So today we are talking about books that I don't really talk about much. So prior to joining BookTube, I read a lot of books, and I feel like BookTube, a lot of the videos are aimed towards rehashing like your most recent reads and upcoming books and that sort of thing. And I wanted to like take a moment to talk about the books that I read quite a while ago before I actually joined the BookTube community and really, really enjoyed. And want to make sure you guys know that I've read these and I recommend them if you're looking for new recommendations that are maybe not as popular nowadays because they're a little bit older. So here are some books that I never talk about that I would like to recommend to you today. The first book I have for you is Beneath a Scarlet Sky by Mark T. Sullivan, I believe. I read this on eBook last year and really, really enjoyed it. It is a, I believe it's World War II historical fiction, and it follows this boy who lives in this town and he's trying to save these Jewish people who are pretty much escaping the Nazis coming after them. And he travels like mountains and this huge like hike with them, and it basically follows several years of his life and you kind of see him grow. And he's such a likable character. Like, I really enjoyed this book because of how much I loved our main character. So if you enjoy historical fiction, so you're looking to get more into the genre, I think this one was really accessible to those who haven't read a ton from that genre and haven't read a ton from that time period. This is a really good place to start if you're interested. And I believe you can get it on Kindle for like really, really cheap. So definitely check it out if you haven't already. The next book I have for you is Salt to the Sea by Ruta Sepetys. So I have not talked about this book on my channel at all, but I really, really enjoyed it. It is another historical fiction and it follows this true story, well, a fictionalized story based on a true event that happened. It says that it was the forgotten tragedy that was 6 times deadlier than the Titanic. It was for the passengers that were on board the Wilhelm Gustloff, which was a ship that promised safety and freedom to those trying to escape war in 1945. You can't believe that this truly happened and that more people don't know about this horrible, horrible tragedy. So it follows these 4 refugees that are on this ship and it alternates perspectives throughout the entire book. And it's just so thrilling and captivating, and you just become so invested in these characters and their survival stories. And golly, it was really good. I think it's young adult, it's considered young adult, so it's really, really easy to grasp the language and connect with the characters very quickly. The pacing is very, very quick, so you get through this book really quickly because you're just so fascinated and intrigued and want to know what happens. So I definitely recommend this book if you haven't picked it up, probably even more than Beneath a Scarlet Sky, just because of the pacing in this one and the fact that it's this true event that more people should absolutely know about. The next book is one that I read so long ago, but I loved so much that I need to own it. I should probably buy this and reread it soon. It's Ender's Game, and I loved this book. If you have not read this amazing sci-fi novel, please do yourself a favor and go pick it up. It is so much fun. I loved the character of Ender and I loved the world building in this book. The twist at the end had my mind absolutely blown. I truly, it has one of the best plot twists I've read from any book ever. I haven't continued on with this series, and I have a question for you all. Do you recommend continuing on with this whole Ender's series? Because I've heard that Ender's Game can, I mean, it obviously can stand by itself and it is works as its own novel, but I've heard that the rest of the series just isn't as good. So I'm curious to see if any of you disagree with that and you would recommend reading the rest of the series, because I definitely do want to give this a reread soon. It was so much fun. And if you are looking to get into sci-fi and just don't know where to start, I totally think you should pick up Ender's Game because it's really, really accessible. It doesn't concentrate too much on the crazy, crazy sci-fi stuff. It's more of just this thrilling, fast-paced adventure story in space, and it's so much fun. So definitely consider picking up Ender's Game. Another one that I personally loved, but may not be for everybody, but I definitely do want to recommend, is Eleanor Oliphant is Completely Fine by Gail Honeyman. I read this book 2 years ago, I believe, and I remember absolutely loving this. It follows Eleanor Oliphant, who is very, very awkward, and she's not totally like comfortable with herself, and she finds this best friend who is like the complete opposite of her, but totally, it just brings like the best out of her. And she's such a witty, funny character. And the way she like looks at society, it's so judgmental, but it's so funny. And like, I don't know, I just loved her character. And I think the character of Eleanor is a little bit polarizing. So I know that some people have said that they really don't like this book. And I can see how if you don't connect or relate to Eleanor at all, or just don't like her sarcasm and her wit and her humor, then you may not like this. But I personally loved it. I thought it was the sweetest little story about just this woman who's coming into her own, and just tales of friendship and a budding romance, and I just loved this book. It's one of those feel-good ones that you can flip through very easily, and you're just smiling throughout. So I personally recommend Eleanor, and let me know if you end up picking it up. Another book that I just don't talk about enough on this channel because I read it before starting this channel, and that's Ready Player One by Ernest Cline. This totally deserves the hype in my opinion. I don't think it's the best characters that I've ever read about, but the imagination and the world building and the things these characters have to go through is so much fun. Like, if you are a fan at all of the 80s and just pop culture and love that stuff, then oh my god, this is so nostalgic and fun. Like, there's this whole thing about like Monty Python and the Holy Grail in it, which is like one of my favorite movies of all time. And I was just beaming throughout reading this whole thing because it was so nostalgic. I didn't even grow up in the 80s. I don't live through the 80s. But I still loved this so much because it had so many references to things that we still love today, even if you didn't grow up in the 80s. So if you want something that is just rollicking good time and is a little bit more sci-fi slash dystopian, definitely pick this up. Just don't expect like the best character work you've ever read. I definitely don't think that's where this book shines. I think it just shines in being nostalgic and having all the 80s fun. Another one that I want to recommend that I read a really long time ago, so I actually don't remember too much about it, but it's The Invention of Wings by Sue Monk Kidd. I do remember reading this, and it is historical fiction, but it follows the early 1800s, and that was a time period I really hadn't ever read about. And it follows this slave woman who is on a quest for freedom and the characters surrounding her life. And it's just a really, really important, well-written, beautiful story. I think it was excellently done, and I just don't feel like it gets any sort of love on BookTube, so I definitely wanted to shout it out because I loved it. And I don't remember even how I had heard of this. I think I was in a book club and this was like an option from one of the months, and I was like, that sounds really good, I'm interested in reading it. So again, I don't remember a ton about it because it was several years ago now where I read this, but I just remember loving it and loving the characters so much and appreciating that time period that I really hadn't read anything in. And the last one I have for you guys today is Gabriel and the Swallows. This book was so good. It is an adult magical realism book about Gabriel, who lives in this small town in Italy, and it's just a coming of age story. And throughout his whole life, he sees this woman in his life that is like part swallow, part woman. And so that's where the magical realism aspect comes in, obviously. But it's just a beautiful, sweet, charming story that you fall in love with and love Gabriel. And I thought the writing style was gorgeous. And I know that it was a smaller publisher that published this book, so it wasn't very widely known. But I was following, I don't know if anyone's heard of Tomes on like Bookstagram, but that publisher published this a long time ago, and I remember reading it and absolutely falling in love. And I just want it to get more love than it does because I loved Gabriel. I loved the atmosphere of this book. And I loved the little sprinkles of magic throughout this entire book. So really sweet. I highly recommend checking it out if you're looking for just like a very unique and magical coming of age story. So those are a couple of books that I feel like I've never talked about on this channel, but I really enjoyed. They're not all-time favorites, but they're just good books. So if you're looking for new recommendations that are not the latest and greatest, but are still good ones, maybe for a future backlist reading that you want to do, read-a-thon that you want to do, definitely check some of these out. I highly recommend all of them. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you want to. I release new videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Thank you so much for watching with me. And until next time, bye!